Hi, my name is Piotr, and I work here at Zmorph as a product expert. Today, I will show you, in a series of videos, why Zmorph is the best all-in-one 3D printer on the market, how easy it is to use it, what kind of materials it can process, and how it can change your desktop into a workshop. Along with the premiere of Zmorph Fab, we also worked on upgrading our dedicated software Voxelizer into version 3. It comes now not only with more user-friendly UI, but also with fixed stability and performance. Let's see how it works. We will start with selecting proper setup for Zmorph Fab. So as first, select Zmorph Fab, then choose the toolhead from the list. In this situation, it will be dual extruder toolhead, and right after that, select the nozzle that you have on the extruder. Since there is only 0.4 available for dual extruder, press start. Now, we are in the dual extruder workflow. First thing that we do is to import the STL file that we want to work with. To do it, press import model button at the center of the workspace. I will import an example STL file. After choosing it, software will need few moments to load it. If you want to import more models, you can click on the import button on the left bottom corner. Right now, we are in the scene mode. In scene mode, we can set up things like size of the model, rotation of the model, and position of the model on the build plate during the print. After everything is set up, we can move on to this next step, which is settings. To do it, press next on the right bottom corner. After pressing the button, software will change the model into voxels. Settings section is the place where we set all the parameters that refers to the printing itself, such as materials that we'll use to print, layer height, level of infill, supports, bottom layers like raft for example, in addition to the dual printing, the artifact. The very first thing that I will set will be the materials. As I have Zmorph PLA loaded on the machine, I will set PLA Zmorph in the both materials position in the settings. Setting correct filament is very important because software will use the temperatures from the preset of this material. So, be always sure that the material in the software match the material loaded on the machine. Here, we also can set a color of how the left or right materials will be visualized on the model. If you wish, you can set the same exact colors that you will have on the machine. It is just for you to make sure that you can see what will be printed with which material. It will get more clear in the future examples of this video. After material, I can choose the quality of my print I want to have. Slider named quality can be set on the highest quality, which is the max left position, or the lowest quality, which is the max right position, or anywhere in between those two points. It is good to remember that higher quality equals longer printing time, so we have to choose what we aim for with our print. I will set something in the middle, so my layer height is around 0.2 mm. The current layer height of this quality setting can be found on the bottom of the settings column. Next up is the toggle option called adaptive height. As soon as you turn it on, you can see that the layer height, instead of being fixed for one value, is now shown as a range between two values. It is because the software will choose the most efficient value of each layer separately. If the layer is flat and do not contain any details, then the software will go with the highest layer for faster printing. But if there are details on the layer, then the software will choose the lower layer height to make the quality of the print better, making the overall print time longer. Let's keep this setting on for this example. Next setting is the durability. In the first drop-down menu, we can choose the type of the infill we wish to use. You can choose from hollow to strong option that will allow you to make almost solid prints. I recommend going with light infill and around 20%. These values are okay for most of the normal prints. Next thing that we can set are supports, if we want to use them of course, or in the case that our model needs them. If we are not sure, we can check by turning the support function on. The supports will be added automatically in the areas that need them the most. We can choose what kind of support we wish to use and what will be the cutoff angle of the support. Cutoff angle is the angle at which software starts to add the support. The closer to 0 degrees of overhang, the more support we will have. For beginner level users, I recommend using 50 degrees and light type of support. Next setting is the bottom layer. We can set a power raft feature here. It's an additional layer under our part that we print. It helps with keeping the adhesion to the build plate while printing with the materials with high potential of warping, like ABS. Let's keep it turned off for PLA, which is none setting in the drop-down menu. Addition to dual printing is artifact. Artifact is an additional part of the print, like power raft, where the dual extruder exchanges the material from one to another to maintain the best quality of the print. Let's turn it on by selecting Brim in the drop-down menu. Now we can move on to checking the possibilities of the dual printing toolhead. Let's take a closer look on the print. One of the key features of the dual printing toolhead is printing the supports with dissolvable material. So, for example, our main part is going to be printed with PLA, so we can set the second material as PVA. Now we can set the support to be printed with right material. To do it, press right mouse button on the support structure. Choose the material palette and then select the right material. Remember the color that you have set for it. Of course, the same operation can be done with the power raft. After selecting the right material for the support structure, we can observe that something new also appears around the print. This is the artifact in the form of brim that we have set before in the general settings of the print. But for this example, I will turn the supports off and change the right material back to PLA. I do it because I want to make a gradient of two colors on this print. We can do it in the same way that we changed the material for the support structure, but this time right click on the part and in the material palette we look for the gradient option. The gradient and all the materials options that we have seen in the materials palette can be modified. To do it, look on the left side panel and look for the same icon as the material palette. It will be named colors. There you will find all the options. Let's look at the gradient. It will be the last position on the list. It can be modified by sliding the dots up and down. Each dot modifies the corresponding color. I'm fine with that. Note that a gradient might not need the artifact to be printed well. But keep in mind that the more dynamic color change will need the artifact feature turned on to let the nozzle leave the material out and allow it for a flawless change of the material. For the gradient, I will turn off the artifact and move on to the G-code generating. To do it, press Next in the lower right corner. It will move us to the G-code preview mode, where we can save the G-code on SD card and put it on the printer to print it.